In 1953, Dr. Wernher von Braun proposed a 50-crew expedition to the moon. The theoretical moon ships that he wrote about in his book, Conquest of the Moon, produces 214 psi in the combustion chamber. But once exposed to the vacuum of space, that pressure is reduced to 0.14 psi. Von Braun clearly stated that an engine plume at 0.14 psi is enough to leave a blast crater in the lunar surface. So much for not being able to find an expert who agrees with me. If the man who built the Saturn V says 0.14 psi is enough to leave a crater, I have every reason to believe that a 1.31 psi plume will do the same. In his video, Webb claims that, due to the spread angle of flame and its height above the surface, the pressure would be reduced from 1.31 psi to 0.3 psi. He concludes that it's not enough to leave a crater. But again, 0.3 psi is more than the 0.14 psi that Wernher von Braun assures us will dig a hole in the lunar surface.
It definitely looks like Jarrah got me on this one. In his 1953 book, Conquest of the Moon, von Braun presents a concept rocket, which he anticipated would dig a crater on the moon, with only 0.14 psi available, while I apparently think that 1.3 psi would not. How will I ever weasel my way out of this one? Easy. Everything I need is on this screenshot from Jarrah's video. Look at the specs on this 1953 concept rocket. It's nothing like the spacecraft that actually went to the moon in 1969. In 1953, Wernher von Braun proposed a single-stage rocket to carry a 50-man crew to the moon for a one-month stay, and then return them to Earth. This is a one-stage rocket. He intended to use the same array of engines for both descent and ascent, so the engine plant was massive. There are 30 engines on von Braun's moon rocket. 30 engines! The overall diameter of his rocket is 8 times larger than the Apollo lunar module. His total thrust is over 80 times greater. His total exit area is over 90 times greater. Compare the footprint of the 1953 concept rocket to the lunar module. Each of the 30 engines has a thrust of 13.56 tons and an exit area over 49 square feet. Both numbers are about 3 times larger than the single lunar module descent engine. By simple inspection, which rocket do you think would be more likely to dig a crater? Now, if you divide the lunar module descent engine full thrust by the exit area, you get 4.37 psi. If you do the same for one of the engines on von Braun's 1953 concept rocket, you get 3.83 psi, about 88% of the lunar module descent engine's value. What's that? According to von Braun, the nozzle exit pressure is supposed to be 0.14 psi. So how can I say it's 3.83 psi? By doing the same calculation for both rockets, that's how. So how do I explain von Braun's 0.14 psi? He's the rocket expert, and his numbers are correct, by God. Well, if you look at my video response to Pseudonautics Episode 3, Soft Landing, you'll see a screenshot of a rocket simulator with parameters for the lunar module descent engine at 30% thrust. Notice the nozzle exit pressure is 0.243 kilopascals. That works out to be 0.035 psi, which is a quarter of the value for von Braun's 1953 concept rocket. What's going on here? Why don't my calculations match the simulator data? Am I fudging the numbers in my favor somehow? No. We simply have two different sets of numbers from two different types of calculations. But which set is right? Both are, actually. A liquid fuel rocket works basically like a large pipe with a fluid running through it at a given velocity. The fluid will have a dynamic pressure equal to half the fluid density times the fluid velocity squared, and a static pressure acting on the walls of the pipe, which could be measured by a column of fluid perpendicular to the fluid motion. If the fluid is compressed into a smaller pipe, and the velocity remains the same, then the static pressure increases. If the fluid then expands into a larger pipe, and the velocity remains the same, then the static pressure drops. Compare this to a gas rocket engine. The chamber has a static pressure, PC, which gets compressed in the throat with a static pressure, PT. Then the exhaust expands in the nozzle to a static exit pressure, P. PPE. These are static pressure values. The general rocket equation shows that the total thrust of a rocket has two parts. One, the momentum thrust, which is the product of the propellant mass flow rate and the exhaust velocity, relative to the rocket, of course. And two, the pressure thrust, which is the product of the cross-sectional area of the nozzle and the difference between the exhaust pressure, PE, and the ambient pressure, P0. Ideally, the nozzle is designed for the optimum expansion ratio, AE over AT, which allows the propellant products to expand so they are at ambient pressure as they exit the nozzle. When this condition is met, PE equals P0, the rocket engine will have a maximum thrust at P0 for a particular propellant and chamber pressure. PE is the static pressure of the exhaust gases. This exit pressure affects the shape of the exhaust plume. If PE is less than P0, then the nozzle is overexpanded and the exhaust is impinged. If PE is greater than P0, then the nozzle is underexpanded and the exhaust flares out at a wider angle, which is always the case when the ambient is a vacuum. By changing the geometry of the nozzle, you can change the power output of the rocket engine. So, von Braun's 1953 concept rocket had 3.83 psi total pressure and 0.14 psi static pressure, compared to the lunar module descent engine that had 1.31 psi total pressure and 0.035 psi static pressure at 30% throttle. Next, why do you suppose von Braun's 1953 concept rocket had 30 rocket engines? Why not just use one huge engine? Because he needed more thrust to lift off than he needed to land, and the concept of a throttleable gas rocket engine wouldn't come along for another 10 years. Instead, von Braun proposed to use multiple engines and switch them off in banks to throttle back on total thrust. If he needed only 30% max thrust to land, he would use only 9 of the 30 available engines, each working at full throttle, 3.83 psi. That means that von Braun's rocket engines were putting out 300% of the pressure of the lunar module at landing. Also, as noted in my video response to Pseudonautics Episode 3, Soft Landing, the lunar module displaced about 8 metric tons of lunar regolith. Just dirtballing it, I'd guess that each of von Braun's 1953 rocket engines would displace 72 metric tons. If 9 engines were used to land, that's 650 metric tons, or 81 times more than the lunar module. I can see why von Braun thought his ground splash might blast a small crater. So, at the end of the day, we find that Jarrah was comparing apples to oranges when he said that the 1953 concept rocket had 10% of the pressure that I calculated for the lunar module descent engine. And simply extending calculations on the amount of regolith displaced by the lunar module to von Braun's 1953 concept rocket shows that it would have dug a crater 81 times bigger, deeper, wider, whatever, than the lunar module. And again, as usual, Jarrah failed to actually prove anything. Ciao, moon hoax conspirators, wherever you are.